Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Firelight 457, and it's time for addressable system test 1 of my new setup. So anyways, let's get started. Since this is a first system test, this will be a non-system test request. And coming up here from NAT 1, I have the Simplex True Alert. And then over here, model is 4906-9127. And over here, I don't have anything. All I have is the True Alert for this system test and my Wheelock E70. Down here, just for right now, I put my GameWare LMS7 for the first conventional pull station, which I will not be pulling today. Here beside the door, I have a Johnson Controls JBG12LX, which I will be pulling today. Up here on the left, we got the system, Firelight H365R, which I will not be testing today. And on the left, on the right, we got the SD365 with my B200SR solder base, which I will be testing first today. Here, right here for the second professional pull station, I have the Johnson Controls JBG12L, which I will also be pulling today. You see it, but in that smoke detector in the corner, that's my SD355, which I will not be testing today. Up there above my interface module is my System Sensor 2400, which I will also not be testing today. And coming up here on the corner of the ceiling, you've got my Firelight H355, which I will be testing today. Down here I got System Sensor RTS151, which I will be testing towards the end of the video. And System Sensor the Simplex 2098905, which again, I will not be testing today. My Simplex True Alert is connected to my SmartSync module, and it'll be doing code 3. And I do have tape over the horn inside because it is extremely loud. Oh, there is to it, ladies and gentlemen. Now we're gonna go ahead and activate the system. And now, before I activate the system, please do not put fire alarms in real buildings or tamper with any life safety equipment out in public. I will not be responsible for your actions if you choose to do so. And please do not watch if I have epilepsy to flashing strobes or lights, as those two strobes are going to be out of sync. Right. So, to test the SD365 with the low frequency sounder bass, going to be using a magnet, and I'm going to be putting it on the end of this piece of EMT, and I'm going to hold it up there. That way I won't have to use the chair to get up there. So, right at the end there. Now we're just going to hold it up to the SD365 and right at the magnet sensor, and that should activate it. Headphone users, please turn down your volume just for your safety. All right, here we go in 3, 2, 1.
Beep.
see, we got audible silence on both the True Alert, because I have it on four-wire operation with the SmartSync module, and strobe on the E70 is connected to NAC4, which is a strobe circuit. Now we're going to come over here and we're going to re-alarm with the Johnson Controls JBG12LX. Here we go. Going to reset the panel, but first I'm going to go ahead and reset the Johnson Controls JBG12LX using my notifier key. Just stick it in here, turn it just like an actual BG12LX. See, there's the model number, it's a JBG12LX. Now we're just going to close it right back up just like that. And now we're going to go ahead into the main fire alarm control panel and we're going to hit system reset. All right, next up, we're going to come over here and we're going to pull the Johnson Controls JBG12L in 3, 2, 1. And before I reset the system, I'm going to go ahead and activate the H355. Here we go. As you can see, I silenced the system with my ANN80 this time. And before I reset the system, just gonna go ahead and reset this, the JBG12L. So just like the JBG12LX, just open the key like that. See, there's the model number. Close it like that. And now instead of the panel, we're going to go into the main the enunciator and we're going to hit system reset. Just going to go ahead and hold down the drill button. And here we go. In 3, 2, 1. Now, before I end the video, we're going to go ahead and activate the supervisory system, which will sound that gray bell. And just going to get my A135 key. I'm going to insert it into the RTS-151. We're going to turn it to test, and the green LED on here will turn red, and the bell will sound. So, and I will also be resetting the system after their supervisory with this case, the RTS 151 as well. So now we're just going to go ahead and turn it to test in 3, 2, 1. It's going to be loud. Alright, well, this is going to do it for System Test 1, Season 2 of the Addressable System, everybody. Thanks for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see y'all in the next video. Peace out, everybody. We'll be right back.